Yow! Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. This is the eXtv cast for the night. We are not in UGC Highlander playoffs anymore. That was yesterday. Today, it is ESEA Invite Gravel Pit. Yeah, we've been advertising this doubleheader tonight. Unfortunately, the schedule was all crazy, all wonky. And the match that was scheduled for tonight is actually going to be played Thursday night. That is the Quantic Gaming versus Classic mix-up. That is a huge match. But that is going to be Thursday night, not tonight. Tonight, we still have our opening match, the undercard, High Roller Gamers versus Snooplicity. Very excited for this match. These are the two teams that are struggling for wins. They're new to the Invites League. But you know what? They're going to have a great fight here tonight, and they're still in the top eight teams of North America. So definitely a lot of respect to these teams. They've been fun to watch as they're developing their own styles. What we're going to be following this match up with is a huge battle for the fourth place spot. Area 51 taking on the Mighty Ducks. Emilio Estevez lead his team to victory once again. Who knows? With me, the cameraman and my guest tonight is Michael. What's up, Michael?
How's it going, guys?
No, Michael.
Woo, yay.
Oh, there we go. You're like super quiet for me.
Oh, snap. I forgot about the push to talk button there. Right. Let me set my mumble settings up, guys.
The mumble thing, or, you know. All right.
Yeah, well, I'm talking to the cast.
That's true. I was the one missing out there. Mm-hmm. The players are filing in here. We got a little bit of downtime, but that's cool. Gives us a moment to talk and go over some of the moves and some of the maps which you can expect tonight. One big change that we should talk about, the addition of Boomer to Snooplicity. Boomer from the Space Whales. Yes, unfortunately, the Space Whales are done, floating lifeless in the sea, beached up on an asteroid somewhere.
Aww.
Womp, womp, womp.
Yeah, that's really, really sad. Now, did we ever get any inside info on that? Any insight as to why that happened besides the just general performance?
Really, I mean, I think that there was just some players who kind of lost their motivation.
Hmm.
Certainly, getting beat up on most of the league is a little tough, but they did have a good start with a 5-4 loss to Quantic Gaming, so it was a pretty close game right there. But yeah, I think, you know, Boomer still wanted to play. I think some of the other players were kind of up and down about it, so it's unfortunate, but they're still out there in the community. Much love to Namle. He's one of those guys. Him and Boomer were the ones who brought me on originally. Shout out to all the Space Whales, but especially those two guys. Zachrol, of course, as well. But I'm going to give a shout out because he's trying to get the TF2 community over to the ETS land in Montreal. So if that is anywhere close to you, you should check it out. I looked into flights for myself today, and man, they were a little steep. It was like,
yeah,
820.
That's a lot of money dollars.
Yeah, and then I checked up for comparison what it would take to fly me to Birmingham, United Kingdom, for perhaps the I-46 multiplayer series.
Mm-hmm.
The same price.
The same price. Well, let's forgo Canada, yeah, then. I mean, it's not like you can get away without a passport anymore, so
yeah.
Not a lot of reason to.
Can I go halfway around the world or a quarter of the way around the world? Let's figure this one out.
Right.
Real quick, before we start, Michael, if you could pull the camera into the map. And
yeah.
So we're going to go over just a quick bit of map knowledge here, just to inform you guys about one of the key features of Gravel Pit that we are going to call and discuss. Michael's flown his way over there by now.
Yep.
We are on sea. We're looking out from spawn. And basically, the doors here, there's a lot of doors and get very confusing. But that's how the teams choose to move in here and choose to attack. It's actually the Space Whales who were the first to tell me this. But looking from the left-hand side and then working clockwise, you can number the doors as 1, 2, 3 being the connector to A, or being the wide connector to A on the far side, and then 5 being the lower path underneath. So it's very clear cut. 1's on the left, 5's on the right, 3's in the middle, and there you go. So that's a lot easier when players are communicating. trying to hold this point, and also when we're trying to communicate to you where the players are coming from. So, yeah, just a little pregame tidbit there, and somebody left, but we did have 12 players for a second there.
Just that brief fleeting moment of that dirty dozen.
Yeah, well, that gives us another quick chance for some shout-outs. We talked about it yesterday, so I'll just go over it briefly, but drop the link in here once again for you guys. pubcomp.com/CVP.
Man, that link just keeps shrinking.
Yeah, getting smaller every day. That is the registration, so if you have a community you're part of, you should get them rallied up to fill that form out and register some players. Also, I want to give a shout-out to our cast on Thursday. We're going to be casting tomorrow, and that's going to be a good matchup, but that cast on Thursday is going to be that Quantic Gaming versus Classic Mix-Up. Not only that, but I just got my hands on a few Dota 2 keys.
Uh-oh.
And we're going to be giving one away.
Whoa!
On Thursday, yes.
Giving away free video games?
Free video games. That's... Plus, it's a video game that you can give to two of your friends.
Wow. So that's like three games, basically. Basically. Yeah, yeah.
Because then you could trade those two for something pretty sweet.
Pretty
and I would sweet. I would condone that. I would condone that.
Condone it? All
I
day?
I would, yeah. Yeah.
Because that's what DFU is about these days. The barter. An unregulated
barter system. Yeah. We're teaching kids important life lessons.
Indeed.
I heard a good one. You know, somebody was mad and they called somebody a scammer because they offered to sell a strange Kritzkrieg for 2 scrap, and the guy bought it for 2 scrap, and then they called him a scammer.
Hmm.
You know, and somebody learned a lesson there.
Yeah, well, indeed.
I didn't even know whether that was a ripoff or not, but somebody had to tell me. It was written in my script notes for tonight. That is a ripoff.
Apparently,
not
yeah.
A fair deal.
They go for several keys.
Yeah.
For
Sorry, Isol with X's around his name. Nice X's. He's saying CSGO closed beta key is coming out soon. And
uh-oh.
Indeed, I know a couple people who got him, mainly Casey Foster from Netcode Illuminati, who I don't really know real well. But
you know they have him. A beta key.
Yeah.
You creeper.
I know of him because EOR, you know, I got my announcement from
right.
Them saying he's streaming it.
Okay.
And Jimmy Wizenhunt, who casts at the ESEA LAN, has been streaming it as well.
Mm.
And I'm going to see if I can wrangle a couple keys out of him for eXtv. So.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
Yeah, well.
It looks like we got a dozen players in here. And right now they're just still doing the pregame shenanigans. But should be getting started any moment now.
I would hope so, although... Moses left the game, coming back in as Schlel W.
Hmm.
Oh, and Pow is in here from Brazil, pinging 215. Better watch out.
Playing some engineer, probably.
Yeah, or some sniper. yeah, Pow is pretty notorious on Pug NA. Plays all the time and pretty frequent target of hackusations. In fact, was banned in his home country. So,
wow.
Power, the Brazilian bad boy, is here and ready to show the world what he's made of. Of course, I don't think the Brazilian league had a client, you know, that is built to stop hackers. So, you never know. You gotta put faith in the machine, and if Power is a hacker, machine will judge him and spit out a result. But, yeah, give him the benefit of the doubt, I guess. Or just keep a close eye on him.
Indeed.
Dee-doo-dee. So, yeah, still waiting. Let's run down the rosters a little bit. Snoopwissy's got Boomer and Big AC, that is Acula, on Soldier. They have Sash is playing Soldier right now as well, but we are in pregame. Snoop is their scout. Sash, probably, I think he's their demo man. Sash is their medic, and 38 Special is their demo man. I hope that's right. Anyways,
I'm pretty sure 38 Special is a demo.
Yeah, 38 Special is the demo.
Yeah.
Thank you. Trekkie is the medic for HRG. He's joined our cast a couple times. Great fun time having him in here and his insights. Biggs Bunny Maniac, not quite sure who that is. Mouse is Anonymous. Moses, their other scout, and then Tech Dude, love Tech Dude. And Try, too. Try is a boss soldier. I played him in some MGE the other day. And Try knows what's up.
Gangster.
Edie. Looks like they are going ready here. So that is a positive. We are going to have Shadow Puppet joining us for the second cast. Or maybe Pure, who was scheduled to join us before, but not entirely sure. Right now, we are starting up Snooplicity on the red. High Rolling Gamers going to start trying to get their roll on and do this offense up.
Yeah,
so they're saying that, you see that in the chat, they said they selected red, but now they're on blue, so. Oh, well.
Just roll with it.
Yeah,
go
ESEA. So. Yeah.
And go rolling out with two engineers initially, and looks like, look at that, HUD reloaded. Looks like they had an engineer on the blue side, too, is that...
Yeah, it could just be there to start off the round. He switches the sentry over now that he's heard that Soldier Boomer is over there, the Demo Man as well. Mouse was dropped for a second, but he came back in. And they're joking about making a dispute about this. Wow, Mouse using some dirty language as well, which is why we have text turned off on our stream. So you guys are missing out on that. Blue's just posted up. They haven't really figured out which way they're going yet. Interesting. Usually we see teams go right for A. I think they're trying to do a fake here, and I think they actually are going to push through B a little bit here. Works out. I mean, if you're the first one to attack, you don't have to be crucial about it, but it can kind of backfire if you don't actually get the times four on A.
Yeah, no. They got also on the Snooplicity side, they have an interesting sentry position here on the ramp. Not seen very often, might catch some people off guard. Definitely, two soldiers jump right in front of it. And it's not even level 3 and manages to take both of them out, so good job there.
They did pressure the pop good, and also I'd say that this strategy of pressuring A worked. That is a longer time than you can see on A, so I mean there are circumstances with the stopwatch where it could come back to bite them. But overall, it is a pretty safe bet and allowed them to pressure the Uber to Sash. So now that their plays are up, they're getting buffed. And I think we'll see them move back out here. Looks like they are going to transition to that E side and move in through the C connector. They're already actually at C, so they could be in here quickly. Don't want to let Sash build too much.
Yeah, right now they're sitting at a 50% Uber advantage and losing that really quickly. And
Stickies are on the right side, on the door number 2. Hasn't popped him yet. Could still get the soldier with him. Pretty smart. Uber moving in. Trying to get the engineer who was carrying a sentry gun around. Finally does take out. Roller is pressuring right behind the rock. Now the pressure coming in. Both soldiers coming in. The scout is there as well. Demo Man's continuing to pressure. Tech Dude taking out Acula, but Sash has gotten the Uber. Was able to stay safe. Difference there, HRG not able to get enough pressure on Snooplicity. Whoa, but there comes Tech Dude, gets a kill on Sash. That is a good pickup right at the end of Blue's initial attack on B. Sash even calling out the nice shot.
Looks like we have a Chris Krieg switch for HRG now. Trekkie's pulled it out, so...
That's a good one. They could even get, you know, a Kritzkrieg here, and then by the time they get their second one, Sash will be getting his first Uber charge. Sash hasn't even started building yet. They're already at 70% on this Kritzkrieg, just moving right in on the point, which I think is extremely smart. But Tech has gone down. They're focusing on the Demo Man, just really giving him all the heals, and everybody else is dying, but they're about to get the Kritzkrieg. He's got to make sure he's got enough ammo loaded, but they could take B just by themselves as the rest of their players respawn as well. Like, I think they... I would have stayed further forward and get the lockdown. They've transitioned to the point. They power. Soli's on top, and the Kritzkrieg's not going to protect him. There it goes.
Yeah, didn't even get the pop-off. Yeah, I was going to say...
He popped it, but, you know, it offers you no healing protection.
Yeah.
They might be able to get the cleanup here because they are getting the kill on 7. Now it is just 38 special, but I think they are going to get the upper hand out of this whole exchange.
Yeah, I think the important thing in that last exchange was they gave up the roof, and that's really the big power spot for B, if you're gonna plan to hold it. So,
well, really, what the only thing I wanted differently there was I wanted Trekkie to stay forward with the demo man, and they were only gonna be able to put times two on the point. It took them so long to transition there, then they gave up the roof and they gave up the entrances to B. They should have just stayed forward, used the Kritzkrieg while people came into him, and had the chance to get crit stickies off. When he was in that tight corner and he got attacked from above, you can't protect yourself with Kritzkrieg.
That's true. Now, 3:45 for 2 points, not a bad time so far.
Yeah, and they're going to move in with the crits here again in just a second. It's 95%. Both soldiers jump. Both
straight
go down.
Into a heavy, yeah. So, that was just kind of nasty.
Crits 38 special, trying to lob crits up, but Pala, two big snipes. The Bugs Bunny Maniac taking him down. Was a very big kill. He had the crit screen, was trying to lob one up on the heavy. Couldn't do it. I'm looking up a alias real quick for Bugs Bunny Maniac. I want to make sure I know who that is. Oh, that is Rick. Rick, the man, the demo man.
Gosh, and now, right now, Snoop's sitting in a pretty good defensive position with a full Uber charge. Let's see if
Trekkie's still on crits.
Still on crits,
you know, he couldn't get back to spawn. And I think what you have to do in this situation, especially on gravel pit, attack once, but make sure that the medic gets out. More important than anything else, the medic has to get out. They have to pop the Uber on, or get Sash to pop the Uber, and then retreat, build another crits, and push back in. Or you could just get a backstab. That works.
Missed that completely.
Yeah, I didn't even see him go spy. I'm using kind of a different HUD than my usual. And that is a big kill right there. Open it up, but can HRG seal the deal? Rick is behind the tower on the ground level, jumping up top. He's got the pain train, but Powell, a big scout kill, taking Rick out. If he was up there any longer, he would have gotten that. Really close. So they're pressuring back in here, trying to move in. They still have that Kritzkrieg. Boomer, top of the tower, gets the kill on try before going down. Both scouts up there. Very quick cap, 5:49. That's definitely a solid time and a great start for HRG here.
Yeah, that'll work.
Yeah, I mean, you know, 7 is kind of on the slower side. Obviously, 2:45 is about as fast as you can really get. But 5:50 is definitely a great start to a game of gravel pit.
That's doable. Now, Bugs Bunny Maniac is going to A initially. Let's see if we just set up some stickies on the point.
Yeah, we will spy right now inside blue spawn, but that's just really a trick to see what the medic is using, Uber or Kritzkrieg.
Yeah.
Really, he's just going to switch back off to something else. Double engineers are up. Mouse walking a teleporter forward. And Moses is also deploying. Hey, he's got a level 2 forward side of the house. Very nicely tucked.
Yeah, that's pretty sneaky, gotta say. It's hard to see it.
Yeah, with that wall in front of it, you just can't see it from the short tunnel.
And it's looking out for the same protection as soldiers jump over this little hut here. They're going to jump right into its path.
Both scouts for Snooplicity on the point. Rest of the team lurking around in different areas. 38 special in the tunnel. Boomer, Fry, I think both were EA connectors. Or sorry, spawn B connectors. Wow. Acula and Boomer find both the sentry guns. 38 special goes down as well. So really all that was just a good exploratory death. by half the team. They saw what was up. I mean, it looks like the gun up front is going to be picked up, moved to behind the house, which is a nice spot, and then he's going to upgrade it to level 3, which is a very smart thing to do. You know, level 2 builds faster, and of course, if somebody walks around the corner, you can kind of stop that build halfway.
Yeah, for the moment, he's keeping it at level 2.
Yeah, he'll be back there. It's got 175 on it, I think. The demo man for blue, you know, was just lobbing stickies over the top where he thought the sentry gun was. But, of course, as we know, it's been moved. Sniper for blue, that is Paua. Knocked down to 30 health. Yeah, we're keeping an eye on what he's up to. The blue Uber moving in. Paua backing him up. The sentry gun getting spammed down on the left side. Almost let the medic take those rockets. Here comes Red with their Uber. Very nice. On top of Sash. Blue Uber faded. The sentry gun was a good delay for him. It was a good distraction. They didn't want to leave it up, and they just had to burn a lot of time on it. Red has lost one of their engines as well, so now they could just have that other guy switch classes, and they're gonna be great.
Yeah, they did a really good job of holding that point there with the engineer actually picking up a pistol kill there. So always love to see that. Definitely my favorite class. But actually, no, looks like they both stay engineer and both have guns up and teleporters and everything right now. So this is I gotta say, this is not common. Having I guess a third of your team being an engineer though is not a bad way to defend gravel pit point B.
Yeah, and of course one of the ways to counter that or to attempt to counter that is just run a spy. One class is able to probably get through two classes worth. Rock paper scissors, that's how it works.
Yep. Uber goes down for the red team.
One sentry gun on the other one's up, and blue
just gets
is
wiped.
Getting crushed by Tri and Trekkie. But Fierce D here, this double end. Some people like to call for a ban of the double engineer, but I think it's definitely a risky strategy. And
absolutely, because if they get one good Uber here, then all their defense is wiped, and there's pretty much nothing they'd be able to do to stop them from taking C immediately after they get B.
Yeah, find a way to crack that.
Yeah, they're on their way though, definitely taking the roof here. That's a good start.
And I know the entries are up. The two. That's also what you gotta do. Make it so the engineers can't rebuild. Yeah. And that's also the dangers of running this whole engineer strategy for so long. If you're only getting one engineer up for a little bit, you can never rebuild. Trekkie goes down, and now I think we've definitely seen where they could have used extra scout watching the flank, somebody else around to help get some frags. So, looks like Snooplicity are going to be able to get in here and take this point. They got some good frags by Paua. Definitely open things up for him.
More importantly, they took a lot of time off the clock. They only have a minute and a half in order to cap C. Basically, going to be a minute even, so they get one, maybe two shots at this tops.
Yeah.
Like, that's and then they're going to be perfect. So, I'm going to say they have one good shot to do this, and
yeah, they got to get in early, and they've already popped the Uber. Good switching around, keeping Boomer safe, giving him just enough focus to not really take much damage from that heavy. Oh, big kills. Brick getting two. Gets another one. Weeble on the top. Brick going huge. About half the team. Sash goes down. Boomer, 25 health. Going to go big. No, kills himself. And Rick actually had a fantastic surf there. You got that on camera. You guys saw that? Oh, that was so good.
Yeah.
Yeah, Rick just surfed himself back onto the tower, and he would have cratered very low on health.
Yeah, managed not to kill himself, so great job there. Looks like Snooplicity is going to the A side, and this is basically, they don't have time to sit here and charge an Uber. They've got 30 seconds to finish the cap on the point, now 20, so it's not looking good. Soldiers going in. But yeah, with that heavy on the point and that wipe there, that's going to seal it for him.
Yeah, I think so. Very nice round for HRG. Good first set. Weren't expecting to be running offense initially, but they put in a good time and a very nice defense.
Yeah.
Double engineer is doing work.
Doing work.
So let's see how this second set works out. We are going to have HRG on offense once again. Actually, I think we should get the switch again. That would make sense to me. Supposed to play offense, defense, defense, offense.
Yeah, I thought so.
So we'll see. We're going to take a quick halftime break here. Might come back in the middle of setup time, but I think these guys are still taking a second. So a quick commercial break from us. Stay tuned for the rest of this match, as well as another match afterwards. Mighty Ducks versus Area 51.
Quack, quack.
Stay tuned.
Woo!
So do you mute the cast during commercials? I'm always confused about this.
I can mute my voice. Usually I just mute TF2 sounds and we still talk.
Okay, cool.
Is that bad?
No, no.
So don't drop any racial slurs or anything like that.
Never! Yow! I think we are back for everybody. What is up? I hope you guys have enjoyed this first half. Or the first set, excuse me. I definitely enjoyed it. Gravel Pit is nice. It's a wonderful map. We watched some Highlander of it recently, you know, or I also played some Highlander of it recently.
It's actually one of the only TF2 maps named after a Wu-Tang Clan song. So,
is there another one?
No, actually, not that I'm aware of. But
CP Cream Factory. I don't know. Maybe somebody should do that. A Dairy Factory CP Cream.
That'd be a good one.
Cash rules everything around me.
Get the money.
Crits.
Dollar bill, y'all.
Me. Yeah. Get them points.
Crits rule everything around me. That's great. That's a new t-shirt right there.
yeah, we are working on those. stay tuned.
That's what people keep saying.
Yeah. Also got, you know, we're giving away Dota 2 keys, as we talked about. We're going to give one away on Thursday during our big mix-up versus Quantic game. That's going to be awesome. And then we're going to give one away for the UGC Highlanders semifinals next week. I'm excited about that. We're trying to organize the teams to play a doubleheader back-to-back. It's going to be on PL Upwards. And yeah, like I said, it's going to be pretty sweet. Pretty sweet.
Yeah, now did the match go live or is...
Yeah, we are live, so okay. We are in setup time again, and HRG on the defense once again, and once again running double engineer.
Double NG so. All the way. What does it mean?
And let's see, I think both of them are walking their sentries out.
Yep.
Which works, especially since they, you know, won't be taking each other's metal, you know, since there's two engineers, there's less metal around. And Moses is going to throw down the dispenser first. Looks like we have one sentry gun on ramp, and the other sentry gun on the bottle on the back side of the house.
Yeah, slightly different positioning this time, and I like that. That's going to be, again, keeping them on their toes. That's what it's all about. Have two Snoop. Scouts going up on the A side.
Yeah, everybody else on B. Boomer got knocked down pretty low and then ran in with the equalizer. Saw where the gun was. 38 special. Trying to move in. Try just stomps all over him. Great shot of that. And Acula went down on Square. I didn't really see that. I was watching Try put the stomp down. But a comfortable times four on A. Sash still has the Uber. Now they can move into B. The timing works out great because here comes the spawns. They captured A, no problem. And, yeah, I mean, that's kind of dichotomy here with Gravel Pit and the A, B, C system. There is a direct hit on the field for Boomer. It's a great choice for killing sentry guns. So, always great to see that item out here. Yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
It spammed together. Boomer ends Big Ace taking that out. Powell getting a stoop on Tech Dude as well. So, now maybe the double engineer be at risk of failing. Second gun is just a level one behind the house. They're both trying to repair it as quick as possible, upgrade it. Uber out, but 38 special went down right before the Uber was popped. Uber popped by Red. Big AC goes down. I think he could have been saved with Uber. I'd like to see a little bit crisper changes there by Sash. Pavel on the side got Rick before it jumped in at him, took him out. Looks like HRG going to hold off the first Uber push from Sash and Snooplicity. And that was solid defense by HRG. I mean, their engineers now, they're getting fully ambushed, fully entrenched, definitely dangerous. They actually have their sentry guns back to back, which is pretty hilarious. The sentry gun in the back spot, the Enigma spot behind the house, is watching the other sentry gun back, tape back and forth. Pala's been getting good snipes here, which is definitely going to help Snoop Whiskey get some breathing room to be able to push in, work these trees down.
Yeah, that was a lot of concentrated spam right there. At least three people at the same time, and just rockets and demo pipes everywhere. They're now moving out along the left side, and again, using the limitations of the sentry range to basically enable it and take it down. Engineer picks it up, though, moves it over, and
almost dies.
Yeah.
And they're going to move in and attack it while it's being rebuilt. And here comes the spy as well, but the spy was pretty ineffectual there. The blue team is doing a good job pressuring in. There's just three of them left. Don't think the spy was really the best choice there. Didn't give him time to work. There goes Sash down to try as he jumps in. 38 special down as well. Rick getting a double kill. I went about half health. Rick, very nice try. Has been really doing what a soldier should be doing in Gravel Pit. Just Goomba stomping down on top of people. Weeble goes down after killing Rick, which is a nice kill. Moses is on Scout now, and Mouse still on Engineer. I think it's a smart decision at this point. I said it on last defense. Team has definitely responded. They didn't hear me, but I think they felt the same as well. 38 special goes down. Powell gets a kill on Trekkie, though. Now getting jumped, Powell continuing to do a lot of work with his 215 ping. Trekkie's saying he cheats. It's pretty blatant. Well, we'll have to keep an eye on Mr. Powell. I don't know. Maybe we were trying to watch him there. Sorry, I have the stream going so I can see what you guys have seen. Power responding with STFU, which I think stands for something not all that nice. But hey, it's the heat of the battle. It's hard to be nice in the heat of the battle.
Indeed. Now, looks like Simplicity has a full Uber advantage here, and they pop it pretty immediately as soon as they spot the medic, and HRG responds by just pulling back completely.
Yeah, which is good, and HRG has an advantage here, but unless they can get out and build this Uber and then use it to stop the capture of B, you know, that would work out. But Trekkie took a big, I think it was a sticky, as they're trying to round the corner of the first door. But they just pull back, and Snooplicity is basically just going to be able to hang back, build an Uber, and then push in. We'll see if they choose to stay over here or rotate all the way over to the other side. HRG doing the same off-classing that they did before when they were pushed back to C. So one engineer, that is Anonymous, and Moses up as a heavy weapons guy.
Hey, I think heavy makes a lot of sense on this point. You know that soldier's going to be jumping into it constantly, and he does a great job of shredding it before they can even put any time on it.
Yeah, Snoop hasn't moved in quite yet. Uber Force pop on red. Powell got a snipe on Moses. Try it down as well. Could be tough. They are kind of doing a good job of trapping the Uber out of that second door, not letting him come out. Sticky's all over. But Rick goes down. HRG in trouble. Trekkie very low. HRG has a sentry gun down on the ground level, but everybody else is getting on top. Oh, here's one scout. Moses with a big kill on Weevil and then follows it up on 38 special. Sash 8 health goes down to Moses. Moses going huge, jumping around, gets power as well. Boomer on the point, gets launched up, and Tech Dude air shots him. Wow. Air shot, shut him down.
Air that shut him huge. Down.
It was huge.
Just roll with it.
Man. That was big defense there. I thought they were going to get finished off there, but a lot of their players came through with some big frags there. Moses doing it up, leading them to the promised land, as Retro the Robot says. And Snoop just couldn't throw enough players on the point. We only had six. Trekkie's going to get the Uber before Sash as well, so Snoop Whiskey still has to wait. Aren't going to have any sort of advantage in that category.
Yeah, they're doing a great job of just, even if they lose it at this point, they've got a great time on the clock. It's going to be more than 5 minutes. Oh, is that a Gritskrieg? Wow, yeah.
Oh, hey.
So unexpected. Does get the Uber out of them. And if the medic can manage to stay up here, they're going to be able to build that advantage. Let's see if he does get away, and already you can see he's at 25%. So on top of them having taken out a good chunk of the red team. Ooh, and now Trek goes down, so...
Oh, yeah. Power's gotten two kills on this push, and everybody going down, actually two up. Just coming out of spawn. Here comes Try. And Trekkie saying nice cheats once again in the chat. And Power had some good shots there. One of those that I definitely saw was pretty legit looking, and a pretty nice snipe. He got popped up in the air and then falling down, hit the trigger at the right time, and got a headshot on the engineer mouse there. Right now, Stuplicity on defense, 728 was their time on offense. Power builds a gun up to level 2 and then starts walking it out. Nice maneuver there. Boomer switched over to Soldier. No, sorry, Weeble is still Engineer. So, do still have two Engineers, but I think Weeble is just upgrading the Teleporter.
Yeah, and it looks like a pretty standard loadout on the HRG side. Nothing fancy or crazy. Mission begins. And no sticky traps at A, correct?
Yeah, Weeble's going spotted. Sniper, actually. See where he is to go with this. Probably just B, it seems. Weeble's getting jealous of Power sniping. Wants to show off a little bit. It happens. HRG times 3 on the point. Trekkie still in spawn with the Demo Man Soldier. And Tech Dude jumping back to spawn as well. I think that times 3 out there to just try to confuse Snooplicity for a second. It's a small maneuver, but Tech Dude going out there helping out. Rick goes down to chat by 38 specials, so that's a nice kill right there. Definitely going to force a different response out of Snooplicity as they move in here. Or sorry, HRG.
Yeah. Ultimately, I don't think it's going to make a huge difference long term, but you know, it definitely did delay the push at least 4 or 5 seconds now while we wait for these soldiers to get up. Looks yeah. Like they are going to rotate, though, through the A side. Looks like that's what they're planning to do at least.
Yeah, the scouts have kind of already lured red players, and actually, they forced the pop on Sash. Moses was around there. Mouse is still running around on the C side, but Moses got in there, forced the pop. So that's a pretty big bonus. Looks like switching through B side tunnels, they make up their minds.
Yeah, as soon as they said they popped, you saw the that's when they turned around and decided to go from A to B, and now they've they come out with the Uber really early. Actually, I think the sniper was probably spotted, so that's gonna be why they did that. But
Rick has not gotten the kill on. Red medic Sash, who's avoided most of the damage. Rick was just totally focused on Sash, but not able to get the damage out. Now was too busy having to reload and hide. Couldn't really pop his head out there and help out his teammates. Rick was ended up being kind of ineffectual in that Uber. HRG not getting a whole lot of support. Not really getting much done. Sash now is going to be getting the Uber in just a second here, and in a nice position here. So Snooplicity looks like maybe they're going to have a solid hold here.
Yeah, they definitely have a great sentry gun up. And this little spot here in the back, which basically lets them control the roof without having to keep the soldier up there. And, you know, oh wow, another, again, really early Uber push. Takes out the sentry immediately. The control point is being controlled. Yeah, players just funneled out of the seaside.
Yeah, red's kind of all packed in behind the house.
Oh, I'm sorry, this entry did not go down. It's picked up.
Pretty lit. There goes Sash, though. Acula, one of the last standing, has 19 health, 38 special, taking a lot of heat. There goes both of them. So there we go. HRG have finally opened things up. And it's a big fight. Let's see if they can keep any sort of pressure on. Actually, they have stickies going around the spawn. The scout is out, though.
Yeah, real smart decision to throw out the stickies and, I like the forward demo and place him, but ooh, goes down to the scout. That's...
Yeah, I got caught on the wall there, which is kind of funny. Definitely a little isolated there just by himself. If he comes out B-side, though, he should be able to reconnect with his team in no time. It should be pushing shortly.
Yeah, HRG's in a great spot. They got now a full Uber. They're still going to have a little bit of an advantage. They have a small window of opportunity where if they push in immediately, they won't have anything basically up against them at all. And
they've rotated over to A-side and are in fact going door number 4, it looks like, up top on the right-hand side. So that's a good switch around.
Yeah, Uber was down.
They weren't expecting him, and they bomb right in on the combo. Red has the Uber in time. And Tri goes down. Looks like Trekkie, very dangerous spot. Barely regenerating health. He is going to escape, which is nice. It's nice. Trekkie getting out there is big, though.
Yeah, two engineers up in interesting sentry positions out of Snooplicity here.
Yeah, I like the inside the house position. That's pretty nice, pretty interesting. That's hard for a demo man to get at. I guess if you come short side and spam some pipes in there, but as we pointed out, he's taking it up top.
Yeah, if a demo man comes out of door 5, it's really easy to get. But not a lot of players use that door for whatever reason.
Yeah, they're actually stacking left side very hard. Right side is where their soldier demo are. Engineers have left side covered. One of the sentry guns gets spammed down. That's a big boost. Trying to rebuild it in almost the exact spot.
And Simplicity pops their Uber charge. So,
did you see anything that caused that, or are they trying to get a flank in?
I don't think anything prompted it. I didn't see the medic took any damage, but apparently he was really low on health. So I don't know what he walked into. Oh wow, a lot of carnage on the point there.
Yeah. Wow, HRG very lit. 38 special could hold this. Gonna be close. Oh, Weevil's sentry gun getting the big kill. Oh, and then the perfectly placed sticky. He knew he was gonna be first to climb up that side. 38 special, 19 health. I was getting ready to call out Snooplicity for a big mistake with that push in, but they barely held it there.
Yeah, that was really, really, really close.
Yeah, down to the wire. They have lost the map. Risky, but those sentry guns paying off. To climb the tower here. Both soldiers jumping in on the side. They both go down pretty quickly. Pressure continues to come in. Trekkie's just going to try and survive here, though. That's going to be his biggest goal. Got a scout and his demo man with him. He's got to keep them alive, not get flanked. Three up for Red. All on the tower. There goes Pal. Mouse goes down, though. Trekkie pressuring in. 92%, 96%. You get it in just a second. There's the pop.
Yeah,
comes in with the scout.
Pretty perfect timing on that too. Right as the scout got up on him, if he'd had, you know, 5% less Uber, he would have died there.
Yeah, it was one of those. I think they were pressuring so hard to try to get it right away. Sash has popped, and climbing the tower with Boomer. Boomer gets a good kill. Actually, 38 special gets credit for that on tech, dude. Boomer was in his face though. I think Snoop's going to hold once again. Yeah, there goes Trekkie.
Yeah, it doesn't seem like they're focusing the sentries down enough. It seems like they're just completely ignoring them. And then what happens is they up to the point they're really weak, and the sentries are just providing enough support to take them down. So.
And I agree. I think that Trekkie was trying to push that Uber a little too fast. I mean, the clock is ticking, but those are situations where sometimes you want to make sure that you reset. He ended up Ubering a demo man that didn't really have a full clip loaded. And was kind of already in a backwards position.
Reformed
a little bit, might have been more effective.
And at that moment, they also had spawns up over their opponents. They had more players up, and they had, you know, no real reason to pop the Uber. And he was under any. I guess there was the immediate threat of the scout that popped up there. But yeah, it would have been nice to see him hold it a little bit longer. So looks like it is tied up now. Is that a?
Yeah, well, that's 1-1 on the sets. So hopefully this config. Issue with Gravel Pit and some of the competitive stopwatch settings is fixed. I would hate to see an incident here in the second half of this third set. I want to say what up to somebody who's joining us in the commentary booth and joining us for the third set of this match and the next map. Shadow Puppet, what's up?
Yo, how's it going, guys?
Hey, what's up, Shadow Puppet?
Pretty good, man. You were scrimming?
I was scrimming, but scrim's over now.
Did you win?
We only played one bit of Gravel Pit, like one back and forth, and we won that one, so.
Okay, I was saying, that's avoiding the question.
All right, well, we're going to take a quick commercial break here. They haven't readied up for this third half yet. Third half, I did say that. But we will be getting this going in just a second. They did just start it, but that's all right. We can miss some setup time for a commercial.
I know why the team pushed in there the red team pushed in with Uber, Snooplicity, and defensive. It's part of the new metagame shift on how people are playing Gravel Pit now.
Go on.
Just trying to be really aggressive with it.
It's forcing blue team to pop that Uber really early. Far back, and using that massive height advantage, you know, without that Uber, there's no way to scale it, even if you are combo down.
Okay. We're about to be back.
Okay. I'm going to keep quiet. I'm only half here, so.
Only half here? Yow! We're all the way here. And I've been talking for a while. Jesus is wanting a shout-out. Well, you better get it going soon. Because this match, the setup time is wrapping up. And Snooplicity going pretty naughty here. They are all on A. And we were just talking during the commercial break about some of the metagame shifts. And I think this is a good metagame shift right here. Trying to hold A. See if they hide or if they keep their presence. They have both the engineer over there as well. I love it. Engineers have gotten some confidence. I think they're going to get a good hold here. But HRG might be, HRG's just going for B. We're going to let him hold on to A. And I mean, everybody from Snooplicity is there. So this is a dedicated A hold. So this is really always a unique thing to see. And there's a lot of good reasons why people don't try to hold A over B.
Yeah, the biggest one is walking distance. Once you spawn, trying to get from A all the way over to C, from C rather to A, takes about four times as long as going from, you know, from C to B. So that in and of itself makes it usually a pretty bad idea, but not only that, it's a huge point. Like, just in terms of open, you know, spaces to get sniped from, it's one of the biggest. But we'll see so far. I think what they have going for them is that not a lot of players know how to push into A. HRG is not going to practice this very much, and got Ubers going down.
Yeah, and Sash hold it a lot longer. The sentry gun for the team has gone down. Weevil is dead. Acula is dead. The spawns are out there. Uber pop for red. Engineer a little bit isolated, but nobody coming in from HRG right now. I think red's going to be able to reform. Scout is in, trying to touch the waters here, but going to run into the sentry gun. Heal the health back, which is awesome, but
yeah, Chucky did a great job getting away there.
Max has got to watch out, though. Or actually, that's Powell, who is over there fighting two scouts by himself as an engineer. No support of his gun. Doesn't take cheat to know that's a bad idea. Yeah, someone's saying they just got home. We are in the third set, and Snooplicity have chosen to make the very unusual A-hole, giving HRG the B point. Trying to hold that A. And players discussing different things that are happening. Some people saying, you know, that they think Snooplicity is going to learn the hard way that you hold A. HRG has had a tough time pushing, and though they don't have Uber here, trying to go in on the back of Mouse, bringing the sniper, which is definitely a good strategy to pushing A here. They also have Moses out as heavy, so going with some off-classing, forcing them to try to spam in to take out Moses, while also bringing the sniper at him. Pawa has gone down for Snooplicity. There's a sentry gun as well. The Uber is popped for red.
Yeah, blue does not have it either, so. And, again, doing a great job of getting away, though.
Checking. Oh! Down with 92%! That's a problem here with attacking A as well, because when you go in like that, you get stuck. Trekkie was stuck in that corner, and, you know, they pushed in on the right-hand side, and they had to transition, and they transitioned in the wrong direction. They're trying to stay active, but the only way you can really safely transition is into B or into C. They hadn't fought their way to C, and they didn't go to B because they wanted to stay active. and Trekkie ended up getting caught there with 92%. So this hold is doing work right now. It's definitely setting a good time for Snoop listening.
Yeah, I'm actually kind of surprised to see that. Like, again, you know, traditionally A has been a really hard point to hold. It caps very quickly, and once you get people on it, it's hard to get them off of it. Is that a pause? Looks like we got a pause.
Oh, that's a bummer.
Okay, well, I'm going to go and do one thing that I just noticed is my crosshair is set to my ugly purple that I use for playing, which does not look pretty at all.
Ugly purple.
But it works, so let's get that back.
I'll start screaming my head off if they go live all of a sudden.
No, it just takes 1 second.
Yeah, and people asking about it, you know, Minimat is saying, yeah, Fatmop posted an A-hold that worked successfully. Oh, we are back, so Michael, get your booty in here. Yeah, definitely A-holds are not seen that commonly. Weeble on Snipe as well, trying to back up Powell on Engineer. That is a good decision. Especially at least for a second there, HRG were considering going sniper. Rick has gotten the sentry gun. And Acula going down as well. Weevil getting flashed with the Uber. Still getting Uber, moving in towards the medic. Oh man, Uber sniper. The control point is being contested. But can't find a target. They are finally going to capture A. The other thing you got to be careful here though is it's not easy to retreat from A. Sash is getting cut off from 38 Special. Thankfully the 38 Special getting away. Sash is trying to fire crossbow bolts in there too, which is pretty hilarious. But this hold on C is going to be a little bit tough here now. HRG has that Uber, and Stuplicity just getting up. Acula on Engineer. We have Acula on Heavy, and we have Double Engineer right now. So interesting class selection.
Yeah, one soldier. That's going to be...
Here comes an Uber as well, already four. One of the soldiers missing their jumps. But a very nice kill on Ash, taking him out. Trekkie pushed back, very low on health. Tech is very low on health. Weevil and Boomer getting kills up top. Scout on the point, one-on-one. Weevil's got the advantage. Has got to take out Moses here, 16 health. Oh, other scouts off there. And Twisty, worn down by the end of that. 5:30, that is pretty decent. It's not bad, That is what we saw before. Out of HRG, so now it's Snoopalicity's chance to beat that. That was what the first set was. Somebody asking, what is the sword melee? That is just a Boston Basher reskin. The Boston Basher, of course, is the weapon that you can damage yourself by swinging it. So the scouts have been...
charging Uber.
Charging Uber. Thank you. Sorry, I was reading some of the text messages here, which was explaining why the pause happened. They were joining to change their loadout, so just to see what they needed there. Trekkie and Try were trying to change their loadout.
Oh, HRG Moses puts up a really interesting sentry gun here on A and takes up to level 3. Let's see if anything comes out of it. Oh, scout runs straight into it. Oh, and it doesn't get the kill on him.
Too bad. Barely works that. The control point is being captured. It's not out yet for blue, and I think they're still going to do the suicide thing, but I think they're considering suiciding from C.
Yeah, which makes
interesting.
Makes a lot of sense, in my opinion.
It's a little bit shorter route. Double direct hit, too, so... To be able to take out the sentry gun? Yes, they do.
Yeah, I think that's what they're going for, is to take out the sentries. They're expecting this double engineer hold. They've done it all three rounds, so, you know, they think they've kind of got their game figured out. So, we'll see how it works out for them, though.
Well, and, see, thing is, too...
Without that splash damage.
Well, also, though, they got the sentry gun, but... Then they should have just pushed in and died. Then they kind of pulled back. They hung out for a second. And then they moved in. And they didn't even really accomplish anything. They were trying to get Trekkie to pop Uber. I think that was kind of the subterfuge going on. Delayed their push in a little bit now. But they are going in now. They got to be prompt about it. The clock is ticking. They got 4 minutes and 10 seconds. That's what's left to decide this game. Either Stuplicity B get C and they win. Or High Rollers Gaming. Can hold the points, and they 38 Special gets one of the sentry guns down with his pipes.
Yeah, every push here is going to be really, really essential. Uber goes down for the blue side, Snooplicity. And, yeah, the other sentry gun got moved.
Nice, though. They're using it to retake the roof. Pipes coming in from the red demo, man. There's Rick for HRG. And Soldier flying in the air as well. But that's Tech Dude getting taken out. He gets an Ubersaw, but last one standing. Taken out, Snooplicity. A nice capture here. See if they can keep the pressure up onto red.
I think the brilliance of that play was sending 38 Stickies, I mean 38 Special, with the scouts, having him be with, not with the combo, separating out those high-value targets and making the team have to decide which side they want to defend first, and pulling the team apart like that really allowed them to push in very, very effectively.
Yeah, they had a scout on the backside. They were coming in from three angles at once, so
yeah,
that's really how you have to push it.
Yeah, you definitely got to try to spread the defense then. Very crucial, as you're saying. Snooplicity has 70% and about a 50% Uber advantage, so they should be able to move in here. HRG just have one engineer, and they're stacked kind of on the right-hand side, Aspire. Their team is. The engineer is watching the left. The level one. Whoa, 38 Special is down. They have the crit streak. But 38 Special going down right away. Pretty unfortunate. Nice rocket by Acula. Takes out Becky. Everybody else going down those sash. The last, or well, nope. Boomer's still with 29 health. There he goes. And yeah, that was a wipe, ladies and gentlemen. Kind of a tough one there. I didn't realize that they were on crit streak again. I wish the color on the Uber charge and the spec HUD would just be different. But unfortunately, sometimes we miss those. That was a good call, but that sticky trap in a perfect spot above the first door, I think it was where he was coming out, and took out the demo man right away.
Yeah.
What you got to do against the crit screen, you got to kill the medic as soon as you can, or the demo man, and then you're pretty much safe.
Pretty much. Crit rockets are still kind of horrible, but... And did they stick with the crit screen? That thing is charging incredibly fast.
They did, and
wow,
they got to be ready to go. It's charging very fast, so they got to be ready to go here, because Trekkie is charging as well. 70%. Pretty sure Trekkie is still on Uber. They should have been in...
Yeah, I don't think this is going to work out for him.
Got Rick. Trekkie's about to get charged.
Yeah, the problem is Duplicity has already lost three people before 38 Special did anything with that.
Yeah, and again, I think they were a little bit slow with it. It seemed like they weren't really able to put the pressure on Trekkie himself. Trekkie did pop the Uber there. I think just to cycle it, get it rolling again.
Which, again, knowing that they have a crit screen, I don't know that I would have done that. That situation, they didn't really need to. There wasn't a lot of pressure on them. And now Snooplicity has a chance to push again. They have almost a full crit screen, and Trekkie's now only at 20%, so...
Yeah, that's definitely a better Uber crits difference. With that heavy and engineer too, a couple crits in the right spot really be the undoing of HRG. As Snooplicity got it in him with this last crit streak. Over the top, they get Mouse right away, so no engineer left. Another player down. There comes the crit rocket getting Trekkie. Gets put down by 38 Special. They're clearing the tower. It's just two up. It's just Troy, just Moses, and a level 2 sentry gun bringing the pressure. Powell goes down. Try up with 80, and the sentry is on fire. Demo 38 Special jumps up top, playing footsie with the sentry. Does get it down. Uh-oh. Wow, HRG with the hold.
Very close round.
What a game. Snooplicity very close on pushing in there. But HRG picking up the win. Very important, very impressive play by both sides. Nice, fun stuff. Boomer new on his team. But exciting stuff by Snooplicity and HRG. Great games, both teams.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, one of the better rounds I've seen out of either of those teams, too. Like, lots of good frags, lots of great play. Lots of good strategy seeing. It's really cool to see the way Gravel Pit has developed from, like we were talking in last stream, just watching those earlier matches and see where it's come today, so...
Yeah, Gravel Pit has really evolved as an art form since the time where Complexity had dominated it for so long and almost demanded and strong-armed the ESEA admins and putting it into the map rotation. And that's where we get Gravel Pit, by the way, is old Complexity kind of lobbying to get that in there. And, you know, they dominated that for the longest time, and the teams started learning how to really take care of that and make sure they couldn't do that. And now gravel pit is an art form, and it used to be this stalematey, long, drawn-out, you know, hour-long matches, and now it's turned into four-minute rounds back and forth of this quick, intense action, and it's all about who can execute that first push better, and it's all about that first push now.
Yeah. Yeah, it's definitely a great map. A lot of strategies to it, very unique. Not much like the other maps that we see, you know, Koth or 5CP. Gravel Pit definitely requires a unique set of strategies.
Personally, Gravel Pit is one of my favorite maps to cast and to watch as a spectator, because it excites me more, because, you know, they've got this 4 minutes to just get super aggressive and play hard and play fast, and, you know, there's this time running down on the top of the clock, and it feels more back and forth action-y, more intense action all the time, rather than, you know, hold at the chokes until somebody gets into a better position, push to last, you know, rinse, repeat.
Yeah. Now, right now, just to give you guys an update, we are supposed to have a second match, but I'm trying to see what happened.
It says forfeit.
Yeah, I'm just getting word from Ender. He just confirmed for me. I didn't want to announce it on air yet, but a forfeit win for Area 51. I'm asking him what happened, so trying to get the word from the source. They couldn't field six. Very unfortunate. You know, it's good to have a backup on your roster. That is a big loss for the Ducks.
Yeah. Yeah, that's definitely going to put them in a much worse position for going to land.
Yeah, very unfortunate there. That takes them to a 3-4. And Area 51, 5-3. Sorry, I'm laughing a little bit. Ender just says, let's get real. They weren't going to win. that's his confidence speaking. You know, maybe they scrimmed a lot, maybe they just wiped the floors with him. But I wanted to see that match, even if that is real talk. I wanted to see that match.
That real talk. So,
yeah, he's spitting some real talk.
I think that would have been a close
now. Do we game. Have any information on the Pinball Wizards Mobility Gaming then?
Yeah, you know, I think we should check that out. We have our title cards lined up. Deuter picked that up as a backup match. And here we are, ladies and gentlemen, hanging out, having a good time. And I think it is time for another match. Pinball Wizards versus Mobility Gaming and ESEA Intermediate. Coming up next, we are going to cut the stream real quick. We'll be right back, hanging out with you guys, waiting for this next match to get started. I think they're pretty close too, because they have 12. So hang tight, we will be right back.